Now we talk about the file scope. So any identifier that is declared outside of a function or a block is known in RL functions. That is used for global variables, function definitions, and function prototypes. So basically, a global variable is available everywhere. Lastly, we have also this function scope. Well, it means it can be referenced only inside a function body, and it's used for the jump labels. Of course, you cannot jump from one code in one function to another function. That doesn't work. Okay, but this is basically, I would say, irrelevant. Nice to know that there exists something like function scope, but we are not using it much. Good. Let's talk first about internal variables, in contrast to global variables. And those variables are often also called local variables. And what does it mean? We know that space for those variables is automatically created when the function is called. It's managed on the stack, inside the stack frames or our activation record. And whenever you leave the function, they cease to exist. And this memory region can basically be reused. They are typically called local, internal, or automatic variables. Keeping the variables inside the function is very good practice because it isolates the different functions from each other. You can basically not change the variable of one function from outside this function, except if you have pointers, right? But that's not good practice then either. So it's a good idea to isolate the functions to make sure that you avoid mistakes in coding. In contrast, now we have external and global variables. So a global variable is declared outside the function. We can also call it external variable. So we have here our main function and we have here global var. And this variable is here known outside of any function or any block. So that's why it is basically can be used everywhere. So here we can use it in main and say global var. How about this lifetime? Well, it lives while my program is running. So whenever my program is started, it needs to reserve the memory for this variable because it is always there. It's always somewhere on the stack and it is initialized. And you can use it everywhere in your code after the declaration is known to my compiler. It becomes part of a global symbol table and you can even use it across compilation units. So I can have two C files that I link together that they both access the same variable. It's sometimes useful, for example, when you declare some global debug level variable and then to access it everywhere. But it's generally good practice not to use global variables. So how do we initialize a global variable? Well, typically we do this in the declaration. And if it is assigned, then it becomes an external definition. So definition, because we reserve the memory for it, as usual. And you can initialize a global variable only in one object file. But you can declare it in multiple files. When you don't initialize it, the compiler assumes it may be defined in another compilation unit externally. And then upon linkage, it will make sure that the storage is reserved once. And if such a global variable is never initialized, it's automatically initialized to zero. So how can we use such an external variable in another compilation unit? Well, basically we should declare a variable using the extern modifier. This modifier can only be applied on the file scope, making then this declaration available to all functions that follow. You can also declare actually inside a function a variable, and then this global variable is only visible inside this particular function. But rarely people do this. Normally they make it globally available. Okay, this line here declares global var to be an integer, but to be an external variable. And that means the compiler assumes now one compilation unit defines, basically reserving the memory for it. It does not automatically assign any memory to it. Okay, I find it very good practice to use extern and then have one compilation unit where I define it, like in this example. So a problem with global identifiers, may it be functions or maybe global variables, is that the name may clash. So because an identifier can exist only once, how can we create a function or global variable that is visible in one compilation unit, because it may be a helper function, a helper, any kind of helper variable. So therefore we have the so-called static variables. Static is a modifier that you can give to a variable or a function. So we have here num to be an integer, but it is static, and so we have a function. Static objects are initialized once at the start of the program with the default of 0, so they are basically like global variables. However, the compiler will not add a static variable or function to the symbol table of our compilation unit. So basically the object that will be compiled out of it, there will not be any information that this object was called num. Instead, it would just use a memory address. So that means it's not available to a linkage, so it cannot clash with another compilation unit where there is an object called func or num here. And this is really useful if you create helper functions. Lastly, you can have static local variables, and they are can be internal to a function. So we have here our example where we have keep count, and we can give it a new value. This is this internal count variable, but we declare it as static. That means it exists basically on our stack in our memory somewhere, but it's never removed, and the lifetime is during the whole program. So that means when we can basically memorize certain information. Here we use it to increment count. Okay, so we take this variable, and every time we call it, we add new value. So it remembers the total sum, basically. Sometimes that's useful. It's also initialized with zero or to the value set when you define it. It's a rarely used feature, I would say, and it makes those functions from pure functions to impure functions, because it has a side effect.